Something to keep in mind with any of the K processors, like the 6700K, or any of the 140 watt processors, is they don't actually come with a factory CPU cooler. Intel does offer a larger cooler that you can fit onto it than what you would get with, say, the R5s. And the reality is these chips are very power efficient. If you're not looking to overclock, that is sufficient. But if you look to play around with it, and it does make for a very nice rig, going for some kind of a liquid cooling system really is a nice add-on. I personally use a 4960X, which is basically the 140 watts predecessor. This is the 5 series. I have the 4 series is the extreme edition, the very high-end one. And I'm running it on a two-slot liquid cooler, and I've overclocked it from 4 GHz to 4.6, running very stably with the liquid cooler. Temperatures never really become a problem. So if you're really looking to get it to overclocking, a nice liquid cooler is definitely a good option. The reality is the single slot ones are more than enough unless you're going for serious overclocking. And for the 6700K, wouldn't recommend going for more than a single slot one, because it the 91 watt just isn't that much power to disperse. If you're not looking to overclock or looking to overclock maybe in the distant future, the standard air cooling system is more than enough. It is something to keep in mind though, that cost needs to still be added to the cost of the processor, because with something like a 600, you would actually get that cooler bundled with it and you're at a much lower cost. But if you're going for the higher ones, keep your cooling in mind.